Welcome back, this is Part-Time Guardian. While working on my Taniks video, which will be going up here in the near future, I was in an LFG group and I came upon a new really cool method to beating Taniks, which I had not heard of before, and I think will make it a lot easier for a lot of teams as long as your timing is good. If you like this video, feel free to like the video and subscribe to the channel. I really appreciate it. Again, this method is going to require super precision timing. So if you are in a group where you cannot achieve that, I would go with the standard group of being Taniks. But if you can do this, this is a much easier and quicker way to finish the boss encounter. This method is called the four ball method. And why is it called the four ball method? Well, in this case, instead of trying to do two balls, which is normally you take the two thrusters out, you take the two nuclear cores to the place the scanner calls out, you're gonna take all four balls from Taniks. Now you're like, that's crazy. How can you even possibly do that? Doesn't that disrupt the rolls? Well, it does, but it's pretty easy to do again if your timing is good. So again, you start the encounter just as normal. The scanner is actually not required. I would still pick it up, but it's not required. The one thing that is required needs to happen really quickly is that suppressor needs to be dropped as quickly as possible. In fact, if your suppressor team, your primary, your backup are having issues getting it dropped, you probably need to send someone extra over to clear ads. Suppressor needs to happen as quick as possible. So what you're going to do is once Taniks moves to the spot that he's at, let's say he moves to orange, okay? Instead of trying to take out two balls, what you're going to do is use supers, probably two Novas. One might do it, but two just to be safe, to drop all four balls at once. Now, the problem with that, obviously, is that you're not going to have four areas that are going to be called out by the scanner. But what you do know is that the balls will never go into the areas that are right where he's at. So they'll never go in. For instance, if he went to orange, they won't be at orange. That leaves four remaining areas. So if you take the four remaining balls and take those all the way to their endpoints and put them in, you don't have to worry about scanner. You just need to put those in, and at that point, you'll get to a DPS phase. Now, one of the things with this method, obviously, is that you gotta be really good on timing, and your operator has to be really on the ball because they've got to get people out as quickly as possible. So we talked about how to do this with the group I was in a little bit, but I think the easiest method is to basically go left to right. So let's say, for instance, it stops at orange and you're looking left to right at the four areas, right? I would just go, I would give someone a number, say every person who's taken a ball, which again would not be the operator and probably not the suppressor, right? But everyone else would take a ball. You would do 1 through 4, right? And then let's say you're at orange and you start from the left as 1, right? Because that's where you're facing. 1 would be all the way where the original 1 is. 2 would be where the original 2 is in the spawn. And then 3 and 4 would be the next 2 within blue. And again, it would rotate. So the easiest way is just to give everyone a number so they know who they are. 1, 2, 3, 4. And again, depending on where it goes, it's going to rotate every time. That's the way I would do it, left to right. Easiest way to remember it. Now, your timing on this is going to be really tight. You're going to be very close to the end of your timer where you're going to blow up to get in there if you are detained too long. Now, the group I was in just said, hey, screw it. We're just going to do this really quickly. We're not going to worry about backup. What I would do instead is I would basically designate the other two players, probably your suppressor and operator, to follow one of the teams going to one location, one team's going to the other location, because if they do have to pick up one ball from someone or have to res someone, at least you have someone there extra. But let's say you do get all four balls in. If you get four balls in, what's going to happen is he's going to go into his DPS phase. What's interesting is he's going to go into 3-component DPS phase. Normally, he has 2 components to the DPS, right? You know, you guys know the plan. You put the bubble, you jump into the middle of the donut, you do DPS, he boops you out, you go back in the bubble, you go back in, and it's twice. He actually does it three times. So if your team is really good DPS, you can actually probably 1-phase him here, but you can easily 2-phase them. And this just speeds up the encounter. So again, if it's something where you're looking to move really quickly, if your team has really good timing, this should be something that you should at least consider, try a couple times, see if you can pull it off. And that's the video. Again, just want to get this out there really quickly because I know there are teams that are starting to get proficient at the raid. And I think this is one of those almost, it's not really a cheese, but one of these cheesy methods, almost how you got through Riven really quickly, where you can get through it really quickly to get your, to grind up. Because I know a lot of you are working on getting that rocket launcher from the raid. And this will be something that will allow you to quickly like use that boss CP and kind of cycle through your 3 characters, which is what I did this week. That's the video. Really appreciate you guys watching. If you like the video, feel free to like it and subscribe to the channel. That really helps me out. And I'll see you Guardians in the tower.